Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. Today I'm starting off with a question for you. Do you send off your projects to get printed at print shops? Well, you want to stay tuned to this video because I'm going to be talking about a new feature in Adobe Express, and that is the ability to add crop marks and bleed lines to your projects. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Here I have a project that I created in Adobe Express. This is a 5x7 postcard for a photo editing workshop. By the way, this is not really happening. I'm just using this as a demo, but now that I say that, I may end up doing this in the future, so stay tuned. So this 5x7, here's how I will show you. I'm going to go up to the resize button here. This is a 5x7, and basically everything within these parameters, within this field right here, is what I want the project to look like or to get printed. Now, many printers need to have bleed lines and crop marks so that to make sure that there's some safe content within your project. So let me explain here. I've got several companies that I use personally. They are not sponsoring this video, and one of them is Miller's Professional Imaging. I send the projects that I create for clients, Christmas cards and things like that, or senior photos. And so what I've done is, this is a 5x7 flat card. Now, every company has their own parameters, so just make sure that you check. So right here, the document size for this project is 5.25x7.25. Now, the finished product size is 5x7. That means that when they print these out, they take it to a machine and it actually gets trimmed. So that area right there that's darker, that's going to be basically thrown away. So anything that you want to keep or ensure that doesn't get cut out needs to be within those crop marks or trim lines. Some of them use crop marks or trim line. Another company here is Vista Print. I'll use them sometimes as well. And they have, you see right here, a safe area, and they'll give you the document trim size 7x5 and the safety area. So making sure that whatever you want to make sure that's not cut out, be in that section. And then they have their bleed line as a 7.12 and 5.12. So again, every company will have different ones. So just make sure you're aware of that. So I'm going to actually design this or make sure that this is ready for this 5x7. So let's go back to my project. And so here is my size is 5x7. Now I'm going to show you where the new option, right up here in the menu, you see margins. There's the margin, so show the margin. So that is the safe area. And then you have your bleed, and this is outside, like the bleed line. So basically what bleed means, you want your project to bleed into that area. So basically that's throwaway space. And then the safety, the margin right here, this is what would be cut out. Now, since this is 5x7, I actually have to resize this. So let's uncheck those, and we're going to go to resize. Actually, let me do this. I'm going to go to view all pages. I'm going to keep that as 5x7, and I'm going to duplicate the page. So I have two of the exact projects. Let's go back to the first one and let's resize this for the printer. So it's 5.25x7.25, and we'll resize this. It doesn't look much different. So if I go to the original, and then here is the resized one. So now we'll get to the margins here. So when I send this off to, for example, Miller's, they're going to trim that. That's going to be cut out. And that where the image will be cut. So that dark line, that's basically no safe zone. So let's show the bleed. There it is. And the margin. So I want to make sure that in this margin, this is what's kept. This is safe. So for example, if I were to have this, you know, out right there, I have the possibility of losing that section of the text. So I want to make sure whatever I do not want to cut off stays within that blue line right there. That's basically going to be the cut line. So let me show you this. If, for example, if I made my image, you know, if I brought my image out right there, then basically when I send this off to get printed, it's going to be cut right there. And that area of my ball cap would be gone. So I wanna make sure that everything stays within that margin right there. So now when I download this, and most of the printers will want a PDF version of it. Just depends. You'll want to make sure and confirm with your printer, and that you can send it off, download it, and then right here, include bleed and crop marks. So include those, and I'm just going to download this section, this page, and there it is. Now it's ready to send off to the printer with the bleed mark. So, you know, also that just ensures that, you know, this is the safe zone, that anything within outside of this blue line will be cut or possibility of being lost. So just be aware of that when you are creating your projects, keep everything within that safe zone, within that blue line, and also confirm with your printers which are the parameters, what are the sizes for the projects and the final trim cuts. And that is adding crop marks and lead lines to your projects in Adobe Express. So now it's your turn to give it a try. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, click the bell to be notified for future videos just like this one, and please do share this video with your friends. Thanks again for stopping by and watching this video, and as always, have fun creating. Peace.